Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Mark Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1868. If an item is missing from the lookup table, add it automatically. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, today's question actually started out of the Mr. Excel message board, a post here by Earthworm, and I fear this will be a great one for the podcast. So let me explain the situation. So we have sheet one where we're doing data entry and our product number, and the description is going to come from a lookup table on sheet two. All right, simple enough. But Earthworm is looking for, once we enter that product in column A, the description automatically appears in column B. But if the item is missing, if the item's not in the table, then we stop, we ask the person doing the data entry for the correct description, and add that description on the fly to sheet two, so that way things continue to work. All right, so now the way I see it, this is going to have to use VBA. So some pre-work that we have to do first. This is currently saved as XLSX. You're not allowed to have VBA and XLSX. Unfortunately, this is the default file type. It's really insane that Microsoft used that as the default file type. It's the only file type that does not allow VBA. So we're going to save as and change that to XLSM, XLSB, XLS, I don't care, anything but that horrible XLSX. Save. If you've never done macros before, do Alt T M S and make sure that you are not set on that top one. You want to go to the second choice. All right. And then the other bit of pre-work is we're going to come back here to our VLOOKUP table. And we're going to add a brand new item down here, just ZZZ, enter new items above this row. All right, good. We need to switch over to VBA, so that's Alt F11. This macro is not going to just be insert module. We're going to have to put it on the worksheet code pane for sheet one. If you're not seeing the Project Explorer, do View Project Explorer or Control R. And you might have to find your workbook in the list, click the plus sign next to your project, click the plus sign next to Microsoft Excel objects, and then double click sheet one. That'll get you to the worksheet code pane for that worksheet. Top left drop down, choose worksheet, and automatically they choose to go to selection change, but we're going to change that. From the top right drop down, choose change. All right, so there's the code that we're going to use today. Now, there's a lot to type here. Rather than type, just go out to the Mr. Excel message board. I'll put the link to this question right there in the YouTube comments, right down there. And you can come down to the code that I've already typed here. Select everything before the end sub to just before the sub. Control C to copy. And come back here and paste that code in. Boy, isn't that a lot easier than typing. All right, a quick explanation of what is happening here. Every time that they change something on sheet one, this code is going to run. They're going to give us an object variable called target that is what just changed. Now, sometimes you might go to sheet one and clear a bunch of cells. So if they changed a lot of cells, then the code is not going to run. If they changed something outside of column one, then the code is not going to run. But if they did change something in column one, we're going to figure out what row they just changed. So we look at target.row, figure out how many rows are currently on sheet two, and then write the formula to the current row, column two, of sheet one. And it's going to be a formula that does a VLOOKUP. This is an R1C1 style. See that I've written the final row in there, however many rows we have. We're looking for column 2, comma 2, comma false. It's like a typical VLOOKUP. I've wrapped that in the if error function, and if it's not found, then I put in the words not found. All right. Now, one gotcha. There's a gotcha here. Before I'm allowed to write back to sheet 1, I have to turn off the enable events, because if I didn't do that, if the macro wrote to column B, then this code would get called again. All right. So you always want to turn that off inside of a worksheet change if you're about to write back to the worksheet. All right, so we put our VLOOKUP in, check and see what answer we got there. If it comes up to be not found, then we're going to flash an input box, enter the description for this item you just entered, and I put a little title there that says you entered a new product. Now, the problem that we have is some people are going to see that input box and they're just going to click cancel, or they're just going to click OK, and we're not going to have a description. So I have decided personally here to be a jerk about this. If they click cancel, then I'm going to assume that you didn't mean to type that product, and I am going to clear it out. So I go back up to the row they just entered, I clear out that row and the VLOOKUP that the macro entered, and then tell them, hey, please re-enter the correct item number. In real life, I would be much more sarcastic about this. I would say, it looks like you click cancel in my input box. I am assuming this means you typed the wrong item number in column A, so I have deleted it for you. Please re-enter. You can make it however pleasant or unpleasant you want it to be. And then once we have the item, so they, assuming they haven't entered a blank description, go to sheet 2, do an entire row insert, and then in that new row type the new item number they just typed and my description, and then finally turn back on the event handler. All right, so you know, 38 lines of code. You don't have to understand this code. You can just copy and paste it from the Mr. Excel message board. Let's give it a try. First thing we want to do is enter a product that is valid. So A107, come here, A107. I press enter and the VLOOKUP gets entered automatically for me, and there is my value. But then if I come along and enter something that is not there, J111, you see the VLOOKUP is returning not found. The input box here says you entered a new product, and we can say that this is jicama. Press enter, and two things have happened. Back on sheet 2, they entered a new item above the ZZ0 with the new item and the description that I typed. So now in the future when I type that same item, it will just automatically work. It's in my table. So as I go, most of the time the description is coming from the table, but every once in a while when I enter a new item, then it asks me to add it to the table. If I would accidentally mistype something, so A101, and I just, I press enter, it deletes it and gives me my snarky message here. So I can re-enter it. So there you go. I thought this was a real interesting question, certainly a problem that people would have over and over and over. So decided to make a video here. But again, you don't have to type that code. Just go out to the Mr. Excel message board, and again, the link to this topic is down there in the description at YouTube. Copy and paste. Well, hey, I want to thank Earthworm for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.